Are you ready to reclaim your focus from the digital chaos? Today, we're rolling up our sleeves, not just to talk about the problem of constant distractions, but to actually build a working solution.
This is TRMNL, a dedicated e-ink display that is the antithesis of the smart display. In fact, you could argue that it tries very hard to be everything the loud, distracting, pushy smart displays normally are. I spent the past few weeks building and refining my custom dashboard where I could get the information that's important to me at a glance.
This beautifully designed, lo-fi, always-on, notification-free display is ready to keep you focused for good. And in this video, we're going to build our very own personalized dashboard for it, showing just the information you need at a glance, no gimmicks, no distractions. Let's build.
TRMNL isn't trying to be everything to everyone. It's a dedicated e-ink device designed specifically for focused information display. No flashing lights, no battery anxiety. It uses a one-way communication architecture, meaning nothing can reach back into your network. It gets data, displays it, and that's it. For anyone security-minded, this is huge. No attack surface, no backdoors, just pure passive information display. The e-ink screen updates slowly, sure, but that's the point. It blends into your environment instead of screaming for attention. Think of it as the anti-smart smart display. While your phone buzzes and your smart display flashes, TRMNL just serves quietly, efficiently. I'm personally a huge fan of the open source cred this device has. The hardware specs are available, the plug-in system is extensible, and the community is actively building. The plugin ecosystem is growing fast. Weather, system monitoring, GitHub stats, crypto prices, calendar integration. The usual suspects are all here, but the real power is in custom dashboard building. For developers, this means API integrations, webhook support, and the ability to pipe in data from literally anywhere. Your monitoring stack, your home automation, your business metrics, it all flows into one calm, persistent display. The open source angle matters because you're not locked into one vendor's vision. The community can extend it, fix it, and make it better. The company has even given the community the ability to have the device poll your own server, should they ever not be around to do it for you. I can't think of a smart home device that has that kind of future-proofing built in, but as I've seen in the past, companies aren't shy about just bricking your device. Should their priorities change? All right, let's build something. To get us started, let's try something simple. I want to work out how the data flows between our API and the TRMNL itself. So I'm going to start by setting up a workflow in BuildShip, a visual workflow backend that plays nicely with TRMNL. I've started by opening up BuildShip, where I'll lay the foundation for what will eventually be the full version of my plugin. For demonstration, our near goal is to set up a simple endpoint, a webhook, so TRMNL can communicate with our project. TRMNL offers two main ways to handle data. You can either send information directly to TRMNL, or have TRMNL fetch the data from your service. For this example, let's set up an endpoint that TRMNL can poll using a GET API call. I'll name this endpoint TRMNL plugin webhook. For simplicity, let's have it return a static string. Imagine something like a profanity historian sends a word once considered offensive. This response is only a placeholder. Later, you can expand it to provide dynamic or more meaningful data. Once the endpoint is returning the correct string, switch back over to the TRMNL plugins page. Here, select Private Plugin and click Add New. Choose the polling option for now and paste in the URL of the REST API call you just created in BuildShip. You won't need any headers or a request body for this basic setup. Skip form fields for now, though keep in mind these can be useful later for passing JSON key value pairs or configuring plugin options. Give the plugin a name, like Stuart's Profanity plugin. Set the refresh interval. Let's go with a 5-minute polling frequency for demonstration. Now let's switch back to BuildShip and run a final test on our workflow. We want to confirm that our endpoint is responding as expected and returning our test string. If in doubt, check the logs. Ensure you're getting a 200 response and valid data. For TRMNL, we just need to return a simple JSON object with the required data, something like this key value pair. Once everything is in place, verify that TRMNL successfully displays the data on your screen. You can use the built-in preview feature for a quick check. If text appears as expected, congratulations! Your private plugin is live, automatically polling your endpoint and returning the data. While this first version might be basic, it proves the foundation works. From here, we can start iterating, customizing the interface, enhancing the data BuildShip gathers for us, and expanding the dashboard idea. Okay, but returning one word is quite different to returning a whole dashboard's worth of data. So how do we go from this simple demonstration to something like this? The key is mastering TRMNL's specific formatting framework, called Liquid, which handles the variables that come from BuildShip, which is then wrapped in an HTML and CSS-like formatting and display layer. Thankfully, once you've got each variable coming through from BuildShip, your favorite LLM is well-placed to write that code for you. I started with the markup of a plugin I liked the look of and went from there, adding my own variables into a two-column layout and having things like images included. Let's be honest about the trade-offs. E-ink refresh rates are slow. We're talking seconds, not milliseconds. If you need real-time monitoring or sub-second updates, this isn't your tool. The fastest a TRMNL will poll your endpoint is every 5 minutes. But let's get real here. Most information doesn't need to update that fast. Your stock, weather forecast, calendar events. These change slowly anyway. TRMNL matches the natural rhythm of the data. For mission-critical monitoring, you might want redundancy. But for most use cases, personal dashboards, office displays, home automation status, it's been rock solid in my testing. The E-Ink display is practically indestructible, and the simple architecture means fewer things can break. So, where do you go from here? If TRMNL sounds like your kind of calm tech, click the links below for pricing and availability. The community are great, and the documentation is actually readable. Always a good sign. For deeper integrations and advanced plugin development, hit subscribe and tell me in the comments what you'd like to see. The bigger picture here is about choosing tools that serve you instead of demanding your attention. TRMNL gets that balance right. It's not trying to be smart, it's trying to be useful. And in a world of notification chaos, that's exactly what we need. I'll include my TRMNL markup and Buildship workflow in the description below so you can remix it into your own personal display. And drop me a comment about what you'd want on your own display like this. Let me know if you built something cool with TRMNL, and I'd love to see what the community creates. In the next video, we dive into the world of on-device AI with the Gemma models from Google DeepMind. These powerful models can run locally on your mobile phone, making them super secure. It means you don't need an internet connection or a credit card to get access to the latest in AI advancement. It lands on Thursday. Subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell so you don't miss it. Until next time, keep building, keep hacking, and keep it calm.